How are you doing?
It's a simple conversation under the most complex of circumstances during brain surgery. Serena Kelly is the first patient in Canada to receive a procedure known as deep brain stimulation for treatment-resistant post-traumatic stress disorder, or PTSD. Sunnybrook surgeons, guided by her brain images, have inserted two electrodes deep into her brain, targeting the precise areas causing her PTSD.
Serena?
Yeah.
Feel anything there?
By talking her through a series of questions, they make sure they've hit their target. These electrodes will eventually be controlled by this pacemaker-like device. It will be implanted during the second part of the surgery and will send ongoing electrical stimulation to the affected parts of her brain, hopefully easing her symptoms. For decades, Serena has lived with the dark and debilitating effects of PTSD. She says she has survived multiple sexual assaults, an abusive long-term relationship, and most recently, the loss of her daughter Harley in a motorcycle collision.
So that was very traumatic and has caused a lot of very intense symptoms. Living with PTSD, I feel, is like being in a prison almost. I can't do the things that I want to do. I don't have a life.
Other treatments offered no relief, but that's where deep brain stimulation comes in, says Dr. Nir Lipsman. He's the principal investigator of a new Sunnybrook-led study looking at the safety of deep brain stimulation for patients like Serena.
Over the last 20 years or so, we've been learning much more about psychiatric conditions, things like depression and obsessive compulsive disorder and post-traumatic stress disorder. And we're starting to realize that those symptoms of those conditions are driven by circuits in the brain that we can access with these electrodes.
It's estimated more than 3 million Canadians are currently living with PTSD, a crippling mental illness that can occur after abuse, disasters, accidents, or military combat. Approximately one-third are treatment-resistant, meaning possible new options, like deep brain stimulation, are critically needed. Dr. Lipsman says it will likely take months to gauge how the treatment is working. This first phase of the study will include an additional 4 patients who will be followed for 1 year. With 8 grandchildren and 3 surviving children, Serena says she wants to be there for them.
I hope that at least the bigger symptoms go away. I do hope this does work, not just for me, but for others, to give them hope.
With Sunnyview, I'm Monica Mattis.